You want to hop on the brake there, Andy, with 2 feet? She was taken out, yep. All right, we can go. Hike up! Woohoo! Good dog! Zach, just up here, I'll get you to hold your camera down just while we
no
park
worries.
Our photographer, okay? Andy, you're comfortable there?
Yeah, great.
Awesome. On by there, Flint. Come on! Good puppies! Good dogs! Good pups! We've got lots of the old codgers on this team here.
Right.
Good puppies! And lots of the dogs on this team, they don't run as often as the others, just because they don't have the ability to.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we still bring them out because they absolutely love it, as you can tell. Like Flint, he's the one just behind the leader on the left, the orange one. He is, he's 10 years old and he pulls just as hard as anyone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good puppies! Yeah, we have 177 dogs in total.
Yeah.
And we have to know every single one of them, where they live, especially their personalities. Because some, not all dogs get along with each other. Like Red, this big boy at the back here on the left.
Yeah.
Whoa! He can only run with girls, certain girls, or his brother Buffy. Because he's a big Inuit husky and he will fight.
Right.
And he's big and stupid as well.
Eating the snow.
He looks a lot like the actual dogs that live with the polar bears and keep them, like use them as protection kind of thing. He came from polar bear country, so. His father, Ginger, actually had half his ear ripped off defending his owner from a grizzly bear. So.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Had a fight with a bear, so yeah, they're pretty gnarly dogs. Good puppies! And the way we name all the dogs, we give every litter its own theme. So a good example is, whoa! A good example is Portia back here on the right. She is from the Shakespeare litter, so there's also Romeo, Juliet, King Lear, Ophelia. Kara's from the, he's the one just in front of Red on the left.
Yeah.
He's from the Jungle Book litter, so there's also Baloo, Mowgli, Shere Khan, Kara, Akela. We've got Ninja Turtles, even Transformers.
Is there a Bagheera?
Pardon?
A Bagheera?
A Bagheera?
Yeah, Bagheera.
Yes, we do have Bagheera. Yeah. I don't know if he's up here today.
Do you want to run?
You can if you want, yes. Just remember, if you ever get tired, be sure to jump back on. I'm going to be running from the bottom to the top of all the hills. And we don't want you to get to the top and pass out. It's quite a high elevation here. So. Andy, where's home for you?
Manchester, England.
Oh, right. United or City fan?
To be honest, everybody asks me that question. I don't watch football.
Good dogs.
Yeah, I'm more for adrenaline sports and things like that. That's my thing.
Your hand's cold?
Yeah, they're getting...
Hop on the brakes. How are you doing in there, Zach?
Yeah.
Comfy?
Fine. Cozy as.
That's what I call
working at the moment.
Me?
Yeah.
I'm in, just got here 2 weeks ago, so just looking at the moment.
Yeah, and just
nothing going though.
Yeah, it's kind of a hard time to get work.
Yeah, it's
but
terrible.
The spring is gonna be, that's when there's lots of work.
Yeah.
Spring to summer. Yeah. And do you have like what? Do you have skills in anything like your?
No, not a profession. No.
Okay.
Jack of all trades, master of none.
Yeah. Aren't we all though?
All right. Okay. You ready?
They won't be really warm at first, but by play that your hands will be sweating in
there. These are ultra thick gloves.
Yeah. Good puppies! Good dog! Yeah, it's a good time for Australians to come over here though.
Yeah.
With the Australian dollar being so strong.
Yeah, it sure is.
Yeah, and things are quite a bit cheaper here and lots of things, so. Cut up, puppies! So it does like red this boy at the back here. I'm probably only going to make him run the one tour.
Yeah.
Because today is very hot for him. He's good for temperatures of up to minus 60, so.
Wow.
Yeah. He's got all huskies, though. He's classed as a husky, you have the two coats of fur.
Yeah.
In your attack, three coats. It makes him extra warm. And they're the dogs when
that's
we get
incredible.
To the temple, when it's like minus 30, minus 40 in the morning, and we're like shivering, chipping away at frozen poo. They're the first ones out of their houses laughing at us. Good dogs! Come on, pup! Come on! Dog. Whoa! You just hop on the brakes though.
Okay.
Good doggy. So Andy, how long are you over here for?
I go back tomorrow. I've been here for 2 weeks now, so.
This is a good finish.
Good, yeah, excellent. Superb.
Yeah.
Well, I've been snowboarding and I've been snowmobiling, so this is my last day, really.
Yeah.
I'm glad I've come out.
Fun?
I'm glad I've come here, really.
Oh, yeah, you've got a beautiful day.
Yeah.
For it as well. Couldn't ask for much better weather. So we start training these guys anywhere from 6 to 9 months old.
Yeah.
And that can involve them just, of course we start training them before that, but that's the first time we're going to run them on a team.
Yeah.
And that can involve them just being on a team once every 2 weeks. We're our second youngest litter at the moment. They're 10 months old and they are so smart. They're already running in lead. Yeah, they're teaching some of our older lead dogs good habits.
Yeah.
And because we've got our best male lead dog to breed with our best female, so naturally you're going to have good puppies then. But we can do it. Hey! And then we run them, they become more of a full-time dog around a year and a half. And then we run them right through to, we retire them out when they're around 9 years old.
Yeah.
But a dog like Flint, we probably won't adopt him out as a house pet.
Yeah.
But he loves it. He's a kennel dog through and through.
Yeah.
He just loves it here. Yeah. Good puppies! Easy!
Okay.
And yeah, when they're around 9, we usually adopt them out, and they're great with family and kids, as you can tell. They're very friendly.
Yeah.
As far as
I love the dogs.
Can the dogs go? Easy, pup. Stop. Easy. It's gonna be pretty bumpy down here, so bend knees and action. Enjoy the ride. Woohoo! Good doggies! Not too much suspension in there, though.
No! Like riding the moguls.
Yeah, straight down. No turn. That's what I sometimes do when my legs get too tired.
Yeah.
I'm like, ah, oh, stop it. just gonna pick a line and
pray. Good girl, Blackie and Baker. Hook up. Good pup. Come on there, Porsche. Good girl. Oh ho!
That was a tough one, Steve. I was just saying that was a close one, man.
Good pup. Come on.
So they do this tour up to 4 times a day.
Yeah.
Of course, the dogs on this tour, not a single one of these guys would run 4 times. Because they're old and like...
Yeah.
Car, he, when Car was a, like he was 4 months old, he actually got ran over.
Oh.
And he was basically like, we quickly took him down to, like this was, he was being trained and then someone ran over him.
Yeah.
And he was gone. He was gone, like not even breathing. Like Jeremy, the boss, he did some CPR and everything and he was not even responding. And then like, so we had the vet on the way and we're at the kennel. And within 5 minutes of him, when we got back to the kennel, just before the vet got there, he was up on all four legs running around wagging his tail. Huskies are very strong,
yeah.
And he had no, we took him in, he had no damage at all. 2 weeks later, he's playing with his brothers and sisters in the pen, he ends up fracturing his leg, just from playing. Good dog, that's why he kind of has a funny run.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
oh, I see.
He still absolutely loves it, we just can only have him run like...
So that's...
Car's the one on the left,
yep,
just in front of the big red one.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's back. Back legs run very strange.
Mm. Yeah. Good boy, Vega. Good girl, Blackie. Alright. Wake up! Good puppies! So the way we have the kennel set up, we have a... So they all live at their own houses, and they all live on chains, but they can play with all the dogs beside them and everything.
Yeah.
But the reason why they have to live on chains is because we have so many dogs, if we had them loose, we'd come back in the morning and there would be a few dead ones, because they've still got that pack mentality like wolves do. And they're going to get rid of dogs that they see aren't good for, like... they don't need in a survival situation. So any old dogs or dogs that are like a bit lame or anything, so they're mates. So that's why we have them chained up. And we all, so on one side we have all the boys that still have everything downstairs, and on the other side we have the girls and the neutered boys.
Yeah.
Because every now and then dogs get loose. If a boy got loose on the girl's side and had his tackle, he would go straight to a girl and he can greet her.
Yeah.
And we'd find out a couple of weeks later. Good puppies! That's why we're, every single day when we're bringing dogs up, we always check the girls for heat.
We
check them in the morning, we check them when we put them on the drop line, when we put them back in the box at the end of the day. Because a girl, if they're not in heat at the start of the day, they can be at the end. And because we're always usually putting a girl with a boy in a box.
So you do the select breeding?
Yeah, definitely. If the dogs had it their way, every girl would be having babies every 10 seconds.
You'd have 10,000 puppies.
Exactly. So. And it's just like with horses or like anything really. You're not going to breed dogs that are lazy, have bad genes and everything, or just bad medical problems, because that means their babies are going to have just as bad, if not worse. So that's why we usually try and breed the better dogs.
The best with the best.
Yeah. Even though most of our dogs are awesome and everything. God, dog! Come on here, puppies! Are your hands doing a lot?
No, great, yeah, miles better.
Yeah. And also the running and like the pedaling tends to warm you up as well.
Yeah.
I've found, even on minus 30 days, I've found myself taking clothes off.
Yeah, you soon get warm, especially if you've got something thick on. It's...
Yeah, like this is, I've only got this fleece on with like Under Armour underneath, so yeah. Like a thermal layer. And I'm hot at the moment, sweating. Usually on the super cold days, the only thing that gets cold is your toes, but you warm them up by pedaling and running. And your hands. Good dog. Come here, puppies. Come on. Whoop. All right, hike up, hike up. Come on. You're doing great here, guys. Good boy there, Vega. Good girl, Black Attack. Come on there, Flint. Good girl, Aphrodite. Good boy, Car. Good girl, Little Torch. Good boy, Red, and good girl, Portia. Good dog. So Zachy's planning to work in the area then, or?
Yeah, so yeah. I've got a mate over in Banff. So
oh, right, yep.
Want to get something there, but I guess yeah. I'll go wherever the work is.
Yeah. Yeah. There's also lots of work in the summer in Banff because of all the hospitality.
Yeah.
Working in that industry. But there's quite a lot in Canmore, which I don't realise. And the one good thing I like about living in Canmore, you get a lot more bang for your buck.
Yeah.
Like, I'm very lucky where I'm staying. We have ridiculously cheap rent for anywhere else, but like, say if you're paying $500 a month in Banff compared to $500 a month in Canmore,
yeah.
You can see there's a big difference.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Good dog. But Banff is lots of fun as well, like.
Yeah,
like so it. Many people. Like, lots of, it's fast as a party town, I guess it would be.
Yeah, it is. It's hard not to go out.
Yeah. Good dog. Mandy, you have just been in this area the whole time?
No, well, I've been to Canada about 6 times now.
Oh,
yeah.
Huge.
Yeah. Oh. Over about a 10-year period, so. Yeah.
You just come over here for holidays then?
Yeah, just skiing, snowboarding, and just doing everything like this.
Are you over here with anyone this time?
No, I've come on my own this time.
Alright.
So, well, the people are great, the people are friendly, and...
Good Porsche. The dogs know where they're going, so we don't need to tell them anything. As you pass the fork, there's going to be a slight downhill, then a really hard right-hand turn out onto the lake. So as you go down the hill, just lightly ride your brake to keep control. As you go into the turn, lean to the right. Keep in mind, the faster you are going, the harder you're going to have to lean. If you do feel like you're going to kick the sled, either way, more break. You'll be fine. See, around this corner, you're just going to lean as hard as you can to the right, and I'll do the braking.
Right.
So we don't really need to brake.
Okay.
We're good. Yeah. Technically, on all corners, like, I wouldn't tell this to unguided sleds, of course, but technically on all corners, you never have to brake.
Yeah.
It just means, like, but if it's on a downhill, you do just to keep the tension tight, but on all real sharp corners, you don't really need to brake. The only thing that you need to brake for is so the sled doesn't, because it drifts a bit, so it doesn't drift too far. Because there's some corners on the half-day trail where if you don't brake, and you're going around the corner, you might drift into some water. All right.
Okay.
We can go here. Yep. Hike up. Whereabouts in Sydney? You said you're from Sydney.
Yeah.
Whereabouts?
Annandale, sort of just outside of the CBD.
Oh yeah. Mm. Yeah, I've got quite a few friends that live in Sydney, so.
Yeah, sort of Annandale, Glebe, Newtown, around there.
Yep. My friend lives in Glebe.
Yeah, it's very close to Annandale. Yeah, it's the next suburb over.
Okay. So. Good dog. What did you do back home?
DJ and...
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Are you planning to do a bit over here? Like, did you bring any of your gear? Or?
No, I didn't bring any of my gear, but I can get it shipped out.
Yep.
Yeah. I think I've got a gig at Aurora's on the 24th. So,
nice.
Yeah.
G! G here, Vega! G! 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 Good boy. And G means go right. Yeah. If I wanted to go left there, I would have said cut. Alright, you are going to lean nice and hard to the right here. And now we're out on the lake here.
Wow.
Beautiful valley.
Beautiful.
Yep, you couldn't ask for much better than that.
Wow.
And this mountain to the left here, this big one that's here, that is the big sister out of the Three Sisters, if you're familiar with that animal. And just behind us, kind of just over the treetops, that's Rundle, a long way to the Banff Springs Hotel. Good puppies! Whoa! Alright, if you hop on the brakes here, Andy.
Yep.
So, I'm going to put the hook in, but it's not 100%. I'll let you out here, Zach, so you two can take it in turns to be on the brake. I'll be able to jump on them as well.
No problem.
This is a good chance to, first of all, we'll pet dogs, and then I'll be able to grab some photos of you guys, alright?
Yeah.